Hey, I don't throw the term must watch around lightly, but if there was ever a game in the NHL that you did not want to miss, it would be this one, dude. This is going to be like a Spanish soap opera in here. It's going to be really, really entertaining stuff, and a lot of questions are going to be answered tonight. My eyes are going to be glued to the damn TV. Hey, do I even need to mention the storylines? First of all, we got the Myers situation, of course, and the fact that Tyler Myers didn't get suspended for that hit on Yoel Armia, and he's got a concussion. He's not going to be playing for a while here. The Habs are going to be looking for some retribution. That's part one. Part two to that movie is that Corey Perry is going to be unleashed like a bulldog here. And I say that. Maybe he's going to come out. He's going to be, flowers and daffodils. He's not going to be mad or mean or anything. He's going to be nice and soft. But I don't think so. I think Corey Perry is going to make his Habs debut. He's going to want to come out with a bang, and he's going to be vintage against the Canucks. And Armia is a well-liked guy in the dressing room as well. So you got guys like Weber, Sherratt, Gallagher, who might step up and go for it, not just in terms of outscoring the other team, but being extra physical. We're going to see some bad blood, some rivalry tonight. And in a hockey game, that's never a bad thing, unless it crosses the line. But in general, for the viewers, I mean, a Saturday night hockey night in Canada, I know there's no fans, but this is going to be electric. And of course, in net for the Habs is going to be interesting too. Most likely going to be Carey Price as per Claude Julien from practice yesterday. But again, Jake Allen had somewhat of a solid game, some would say. So he could also easily be put in net, but it's looking like it's going to be Carey Price for right now. And as far as the lines go, first two lines unchanged for Montreal: Tatar, Danault, Gallagher, Drouin, Suzuki, and Anderson. On the third line is where things get interesting. Mr. Hat-trick Toffoli with Kotkaniemi and Corey Perry on that third line. And then the fourth line, if Byron can't go, it's going to be Michael Frolik, Evans, and Lehkonen. And on D, the pairings are unchanged from what we've seen for a while. But to me, the key to victory tonight for Montreal, and let me say this one for the people in the back, okay, in the Montreal Forum, stay out of the box. That is the key for Montreal tonight, dude. How many penalties? I know a lot of them were not their fault. Okay, there was a lot of penalties, like the ref should kind of put the whistle, like chill a little bit, okay, ref? But still, you gotta be disciplined, stay out of the box. I know it hasn't bit them lately, but trust me, it will. Hey, and on the Vancouver side, ugh, so annoying how Travis Green does this, but I get why he does it. I was searching long and hard, searching longer and harder than Pierre-Luc Dubois looking for a hiding spot to not have to face John Tortorella. But look, I couldn't find the line pairings for Vancouver for this game tonight. Unless we see a morning skate, that's when we're going to figure it out. But until then, mum's the word for Vancouver. They want to keep it hush. But if you ask me, one thing's for sure: Braden Holtby is going to be in the net because Demko didn't get pulled last game when he was getting lit up. So Holtby's definitely getting the start. But the lineup has been shaky, so I'm sure there's going to be some changes. And we got, that was what, 16 injuries on defense. So obviously there's going to be some changes back there too, but I can't find it. It's going to be completely mixed up. In Daily Faceoff, the site I usually get the daily line combinations for, they're wrong. Okay, they've got Jalen Chatfield still there, and I don't think that's going to happen. I think he's hurt, right? I don't know what kind of secrets Travis Green is planning. Maybe he's going to bring out the Sedin twins or something. They're going to like come down from the rafters and play for the Canucks or whatever. But what I can tell you is no Rafferty. He's on the taxi squad. Chatfield is injured. Jordy Benn is going to come in and play for the Vancouver Canucks, and Holtby's going to be in net. And expect a bunch of shakeups up front. Okay, Pettersson's not going. I know they want to get him going with the Lotto 649 line, but they're going to start shuffling some things around with a bunch of different players. Horvat is really playing well, so expect him to really be the focal point now for this Canucks team. But yeah, expect a bunch of shakeups and just, I mean, pray to your gods, Vancouver. Pray to Marcus Naslund and Trevor Linden and Kevin Bieksa. But yeah, my key to victory for the Canucks, man, it's incredibly obvious. Even Stevie Wonder could see this one. It's your star players have to get off the schneid. I'm looking at you, Pettersson. I'm looking at you, Miller. Less looking at Besser because he did have those two goals the night before. If I'm really pointing it at somebody, I'm not going to sugarcoat it, skate around it. It's Pettersson. Elias Pettersson, you are the marquee star on this team, supposed to be the number one center, although Bo Horvat is really looking to be the number one center on this team now. But Pettersson's supposed to be your marquee star. He's got to pick it up. I think he's got like 1 point, man. Really needs to pick things up. If he does, I think that'll give the whole team a boost. I think, because you can see it on his face, he looks dead inside lately. But I think if he starts to pick it up, everybody's confidence is going to go up. Everybody's going to start shooting it up, I think. I really think it's going to do good for the entire team. And I know it's crazy. One player can jolt the entire team. Yes. And another thing I'll say here, look, the defense, oof, it looks like a beer leaguer's defense. My buddy CA Sports said that to me the other day. The goalie. If you can steal one here tonight, Holtby, like vintage Holtby with the Caps, that would really help for the Canucks. So Holtby needs to be stellar too, if the Canucks want any chance of winning this one. That's going to do it for me on this one, guys. Let me know down below. Predictions. What do we got? Not just for the game, the score. What do you think is going to happen? Is there going to be some bad blood? Are we going to witness UFC tonight? Is that what this is going to be? WWE? Or is this just going to be kind of like, okay, let's just move on and focus on the 2 points tonight? What do you guys think is going to happen? Let me know in the comments down below. If you're new here, hockey content every single day. Try to add my own little spice to it. And yeah, like this video, subscribe. See you in the next one.